My idea was to wrap the whole building in chains, you know, like ship's anchor chains, big fuckers, you know, and wrap this thing in and lock every fucker out for the entirety of the Bienalle. So, you know, like it became a non-capitalist, you know, issue, you know, like, it put art front and centre, you know, like, this sculpture would have attracted so much attention, like, from people. The other aspect of my proposal was to have a tent embassy to discuss the issues that thing there raised. That's it. So
you put this together. It's such a great concept, and obviously it's sort of like the essence of what your work is. So as an artist, yeah, you're building something extraordinary, and you know, within that space, it resonates so powerfully because it speaks to the world around issues of the world. It's not just an Australian race issue; it's a freaking global issue. And as you said earlier, it's not just the people of race that are locked out.
Yeah.
It's women are locked out, and people with handicap and disabilities are locked out. Like, there's so many people that are locked out, and I think that's what it's such a symbolically powerful piece of work. So you put this forward, and you got on the shortlist, but you.
Yeah, well, I call it. We don't really need this. And I don't, because you're like, I'm going to show them. I didn't really need them to pick me. You're like, I'm going to go there, and instead of wrapping their Australian pavilion in chains, I'm going to build a model and wrap that in chains, put it on a boat, and sail it up and down past the Bienalle.
Yes.